The Eastern Caribbean Telecommunications Authority, ECTEL, is a regulatory body that oversees electronic communications in five member states, namely St. Lucia, Dominica, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Grenada, and St. Kitts and Nevis. In each member state, there is a national regulatory commission charged with the responsibility of ensuring that providers abide by the rules. One of the most important projects currently being undertaken by the authority is to pass the Electronic Communications Bill to regulate the activities of electronic communications providers and ensuring protection of consumer rights in all of the member states at a time when the role of the ICT sector was brought into sharp focus with the advent of the COVID-19 pandemic.
On Thursday, 28th October, Senior Minister King chaired the 42nd meeting of the ECTEL Council of Ministers. And at that meeting, he had the important task of leading the Council of Ministers in considering and approving the budget that will fund a very ambitious work plan for ECTEL and the NTRCs, the National Telecommunications Regulatory Commissions. And the main focus of this work plan will be the transition to a new regulatory system with the promulgation of the EC Bill in our member states.
This is a pivotal moment in the development of the telecommunications sector. It encompasses the transition from a regulatory regime that prompted liberalization and competition within the sector to a regime that will provide the platform for the digital transformation of the economies in the ECTEL member states.
In the past 8 months, whilst we lived through the unprecedented global pandemic, access to broadband service proved to be a lifeline as many accept aspects of everyday life could only continue thanks to the shift to digital services. Across the ECTEL member states, the sector demonstrated some level of resilience as to some extent the service providers were able to meet the increase in demand on the networks.
However, the pandemic exposed the digital divide between households where persons were able to make the transition almost seamlessly to online learning and working from home, to households in which persons had limited access or no access at all to broadband service. It's now up to the authorities to bridge that divide. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.